A first half hat trick Thursday night for Kristen Press was plenty as the U.S. rolled Romania 8-1. Tonight in L.A., the reigning World Cup champs close out the calendar year with their second all-time meeting with Romania. And we welcome you to the pregame show brought to you by AT&T, the number one ranked team in the world, seeks their 22nd win of the year next year at the StubHub Center in Carson, California. Glad you're here with us for our truncated pregame show. Rob Stone, Alexi, Lalas with you. Excited to see the influx of new young talent. One of the reasons there's so many new faces out there is because some of the vets are moving on. Heather O'Reilly was a fan Thursday, a talking head today, and she was a star through her years with this U.S. women's national team before she excelled for the red, white, and blue, won a couple NCAA titles for the North Carolina Tar Heels, 3 Olympic gold medals, 1 NWSL crown, and of course, the Women's World Cup title in Canada. How's it feel to be a talking head, my friend?
Well, thanks for all that, Rob. I mean, I feel wonderful about my contribution to the women's national team, and now I'm seeing a little bit of a different side to it. And I'm so thrilled to be here watching my teammates, and I'm just thrilled to have this opportunity to.
I'm not sure they're used to seeing you over here. A couple of them were giving you some looks, and you know, without the ponytail, it's a completely different hey-o sometimes, isn't it?
Yeah, hey, different look, but you know, I'm on to other life dreams now, and that's hanging out with Alexi Lalas on national television.
I mean, does it get any better than hanging out with Alexi Lalas? Let's take a look at our starting line. It is your first starting lineup, Heather O'Reilly.
Yes.
Nail
here
it.
We go.
All right, let's take a look at the 11 for the U.S.
And in goal for the USA, we have Alyssa Nair in a 3-4-3 formation. We have Becky Sauerbrunn, Ali Long, who historically has played center midfield for the U.S. national team, and Casey Short on the left. Then we have Annie Sullivan, Morgan Bryan in center midfield, Kalia Ojai on that right side, trying to prove herself and earn time. Crystal Dunn leading the way for that forward line for the USA, dynamic winger, and she will be popping inside to add a number to that USA midfield.
And Alex Morgan available on the bench. Romania ranked 36th in the world, Mr. Lawless.
Oh, Rob Stone, you know him, you love him. Romania, coached by Mirella Albon. Roxana Oprah in goals. She shipped 8 goals, as we said, on Thursday. Got to do better tonight. But up top, we're talking about Laura Russ, 21 international goals and scored Thursday against the U.S. Also paired with Stefania Vatafu, led the team with 4 goals in the Euro 2017 qualification. But keep in mind, this is a team that's never qualified for a FIFA or UEFA tournament.
For another layer to this game, let's send it upstairs to your match announcers, JP Dellacamera and Aly Wagner.
Thank you, Rob. Well, Jill Ellis has plenty of time before the next major tournament, the next World Cup in 2019. So, Aly, what is she looking at these days?
Well, the first thing, and probably the most important thing, is she's looking to broaden the player pool. She wants to bring in more NWSL players, players from the collegiate game, and players from the youth national team. And this is really all for the ultimate goal of creating a more competitive environment for those roster spots. She no longer wants it to be assumed you're called in. She wants to be earned based on your current performance. And within that player pool, she wants players that are versatile, players that can play more than one spot, so she can change things up tactically on the fly without having to make substitutions. And lastly, she's looking at formations. They've used a 3-back system in the last 3 games. They're going to employ it again tonight. And even if they don't land on it, it's about checking out the strengths and weaknesses of those systems and ultimately having more tools in their arsenal come 2019 in France for the World Cup so they can evolve and defend their title.
And one of the players who checks all of those boxes in a positive way is Andy Sullivan. She's downstairs with our Jenny Taft.
Andy, the first time we spoke, it was after your first national team game. You said you wanted to take everything minute by minute. Now, you've had a few more caps under your belt. So how comfortable are you feeling with the national team?
I'm getting a little bit more comfortable as it's going along, but it's still, you know, insane to play in front of this many people and with, you know, a bunch of different players and a new system and obviously just at this level in general. So I feel like I'm, you know, doing okay, but I'm just excited for, you know, to keep progressing and keep getting better if it keeps going.
And your 4th straight start tonight, how is your role in the midfield being more defined?
That's a good question. I'm just trying to get a good relationship with Mo Bryan going on and looking to just play forward as much of the targets as possible and just hustling on D and just, you know, trying to carry out all this team's principles, just particularly in the midfield.
Well, thank you so much. Best of luck today.
Thanks so much.
Jill Ellis said of Sullivan, quote, she's a player that has the two attributes that are going to be the core of this team, a brain and good feet. The U.S. and Romania kick it off in 13 and a half minutes. The 2019 Women's World Cup in France kicks off in 930 days, but the final match of this calendar year for the U.S. Women's National Team kicks off next, live on FS1.
The national team is back in Southern California.
Sister Dunn bends it in. What a goal!
Where they played 10 times before. And where they won 10 times before. So, let's make it 11.
Across the way, there's Heath.
The United States versus Romania, next on FS1.
And now, U.S. Soccer presents...
Beautiful night in Southern California as we're closing in on kickoff between the U.S. Women's National Team, ranked number one in the world, hosting Romania, the second time these two nations have met over the course of the last 4 days. Rob Stone, Heather O'Reilly, Alexi Lalas here with you. And if you're a U.S. fan, you're hoping maybe tonight might be able to take out a little bit of the sting from Friday night's U.S. men's loss to Mexico. Two teams making their way out to the field right now.
Well, Lynn Williams has had such a successful club professional season, and she's looking to make her mark with the women's national team tonight.
You mentioned it, Rob, on a week when we're talking so much about decisions from coaches and experimentation with Jurgen Klinsmann. This is the type of game, this is the type of night where you do experiment. I'm interested to see whether it's the back three or whether it's players like Sullivan, whether it's players like Williams, how do they play?
Ojai made her first start last game and her second ever international appearance. We heard from Andy Sullivan in the pregame show. Still just a collegiate player, a junior at Stanford, but it sounds like she's kind of cemented her spot on this U.S. women's national team.
Well, Andy Sullivan has played like a seasoned veteran. She is a natural number six, a holding midfielder, which the U.S. team has been in search for so long.
What are some of the things that you believe Jill Ellis is hoping to take away from a game that they should win handily to conclude this season?
Well, listen, it's been a year of transition for the U.S. women's national team. So I think that she's going to be looking to end 2016 on a high note, have some of these young players like Kalia Ojai, like Lynn Williams, really make their impact known and add some positivity going into 2017.
Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing and welcome Joseph Silva to sing the Star Spangled Banner.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free?
Thursday night, the U.S. dominated this Romanian side 8-1. What will the score line be tonight? The three of us will join you next at halftime. Now we send it upstairs for the call of this one. JP Dellacamera and Aly Wagner.
Thank you so much, Rob. USA versus Romania. Second time they've met in the last few days. And before we get this game started, Jenny Taft is downstairs with the USA's head coach, Jill Ellis. Jen?
JP, thank you. Well, Jill, with this match wrapping up the 2016 schedule, what are the expectations for the team tonight?
Well, it's, I said to them in the first 5 minutes, we'll get an indication of where we are. And, it, you know, it's to finish the season and finish this year with a good performance. And, you know, I said to them, we've got a break coming up. We've got 90 minutes of work to get done.
Okay, thank you for your time.
All right, bye-bye.
JP?
Thank you, Jenny. USA will be, for the fourth straight time, going with three in the back. It'll be a 3-4-3 formation. Speaking of three, here are three things to watch from Aly.
Well, I mean, there's a couple things. The three-back system is something that's everyone's been talking about, everyone's been interested in, and there's been gripes about it. But look, this is tinkering time. This is the time to explore. Can this personnel execute? And as Alexi said, you don't do it in big games. You do it in games like this. And they've been exposed twice. They've conceded two goals on it, and it's something to continue watching. And then as far as regains, that's something that she's pressed over and over and over again. It's about that transition to defense in the attacking third so they can win it high on the field and attack constantly. And then a glimpse without Carly Lloyd. It's something that the team has to be prepared for. They want to be able to perform without her, but she's a player like none other that can break open a game with just her shot alone and when she gets in that attacking third. But, you know, we get to see what the future might look like if she's not a part of the picture in 2019.
She recently got married on her honeymoon. That's why she was not with this team as they close out 2016. Expected to close it out undefeated for the third time in their history in a season in which they've played in 10 or more games. Last time they did it, 2013. That's the man in charge of Romania, Mirel Albon. Says that even though they lost 8-1, Aly, he got a lot out of that game because to learn, you have to play against the best.
You do, and you're facing the best in this U.S. team. They are on fire. 8 goals can expose a lot of weaknesses in a team, and we're going to see if they learn from that match.
USA in the dark uniforms, Romania in yellow. Margaret Domka, match referee, will blow the whistle and get this one started. Final game of the 2016 calendar year for the U.S. Women's National Team. This is underway with Ojai pushing it back to Sauerbrunn, looking for Aly Long. normally more of a holding midfielder. How has she adjusted to playing center back in the back three?
Well, as far as her attacking presence, it's been brilliant. She plays amazing penetrating passes, beats line of defense time and time again, and opens things up. She's like a quarterback back there. But she's had some moments defensively that have cost the U.S., and that's just a learning curve for her. She's never played in the back line, and this is, again, a test to see if she can play ultimately against some of the best teams in that role.
Sauerbrunn moving it ahead, looking for Crystal Dunn. That's picked up by Borton, Romania's captain on these two games. All the way back to Alyssa Nair in goal, making her 10th appearance, 6th of the season.
And the U.S. is lining up in their 3-4-3, and we can see immediately that they're having the expansive shape in the midfield part where they're the ones that are supplying the width, not those front three. Those front three are staying pinched in.
Ball sent in long, and it's going to be too long, intended for Lynn Williams. She's one of the players when we talked about widening the pool that's getting an opportunity to play for the U.S.
And she's taken it and hasn't looked back, scoring in her first cap 49 seconds in and continuing to get the start. Same thing with Casey Short. So many coaches say they're willing to look at other players, but Jill Ellis has truly proved that, and she's basing her selections on their performance in training.
Russ will win possession back. All the way back again to Aly Long. Sauerbrunn to the right. Long. Short. Casey Short's club team, Chicago Red Stars. Fourth straight start for Short. Sullivan trying to lead that for Press. Long run for her. Even with her speed, she couldn't get to that ball. It's a goal kick for Oprah.
And it's early in the game. Jill said, watch the first 5 minutes. Look at our pressure. We'll see where we're at. And you can just see that's Kristen Press battling, hounding, trying to win that ball in the attacking third for the U.S.
Coming up a hat trick in 38 minutes the other night. Goals in three consecutive games for Kristen Press.
And something she's working on in particular, it's hounding, being a pain defensively. But then as soon as they win the ball, having the calmness, the presence to just settle things down and connect and not squander possession.
Long with it, her club team, Portland Thorns of the NWSL, for Sauerbrunn. More pressure on her from both of them. Fiche. It's going to be a throw-in for the U.S. Four lineup changes from Thursday night for Romania. We're told no injuries, so that's not the reason for any changes. Borton lost it there. U.S. collects. Sauerbrunn. Done. There's a chip from Borton. Margaret Domka right on it. Free kick, U.S.
And that's the pressure. In the attacking third for the U.S., they force that turnover, and immediately they earn a dangerous free kick.
Sullivan out wide. Ball pushed right into the middle, deflected over. Tobin Heath, first one on it with that chip. Oprah, the goalkeeper, came out. That's her ball. She had to claim it. She does. Good distribution on this side. Voicu. 10 in the yellow of Romania. Borton back for Voicu. Keeping it in play on that side. Borton blocked. It's Morgan Bryan getting stuck in. Batafu lost it. In the middle, it's Andy Sullivan. In her junior year at Stanford, she's having another strong soccer season. Sullivan's the only collegiate player on this U.S. squad. Ball to switch, right side, Ojai. Stays with it. Ojai almost got through that double team. Still be a throw-in to the U.S. The U.S. looking. Ojai. Sauerbrunn. That's cleared away. Romania can't break out. They give it away in a bad spot. Tobin Heath. Kristen Press. Inside it comes. Bryan shot. Rebound wide from Dunn. That first goal of the game was right there.
And look, this is something that Mirel Albon talked about, not creating mistakes individually if you're Romania and not turning the ball over in dangerous areas. That was the difference, he thought, between the U.S.'s 8-1 victory. I think there was more to it, obviously, but the important thing was taking care of the ball, not squandering possession in dangerous areas, and early on we're seeing it from Romania.
U.S. has got to have enough of the ball tonight without you giving it back to them so easily.
Exactly, and you can't discount that their pressure is forcing those turnovers, but ultimately Romania has numbers around the ball. It's just the composure to connect and play out of that pressure.
Oh, hi for Crystal Dunn. Big cross to the middle, headed up. Wide again of Oprah. We'll have a goal kick for Romania.
And one thing that I was impressed with Romania is they were able to find those seams between the center midfielders and the outside mids in that game in San Jose on Thursday night. And the U.S. was having a hard time solving it. That's ultimately where they conceded the goal from that gap, from that space. Becky Sauerbrunn stepped late, and it was a domino effect. Aly Long wasn't dropping. So I'm looking to see how they solve that space in the center of midfield.
Sauerbrunn high up the field from the right back spot. Looping it in. That was cleared. And out for a corner kick. A very advanced position from Becky Sauerbrunn on that last attack. Played short to Sauerbrunn. Dunn looking. Got by one, slotting it in, oh high, end line cross. Knocked out another USA corner kick. Last time they went short with it. Let's see what they do this time. Morgan Bryan's going to come over. Bryan drives it. Second ball, knotted down. Ojai kept it moving. U.S. will get to it. Done. Look at those moves. There's another. Sending it across. Two players from the U.S. went at it and maybe took each other out of the play. Dunn, look at that quick turn. Another. Crystal Dunn in. Looking. Shooting. Save made by Oprah. What a terrific 30 seconds or so from Crystal Dunn.
It's exactly what Crystal Dunn can do, is just slice it up, beat one, two, three players at a time, and she's doing it time and time again. And what's better from Romania, though, on the flip side, is their discipline in the box to get back and mark those players when that service is coming in. But individually, they're just diving in too soon, and it's very easy for Crystal Dunn to have success getting in and around the box.
Played the last 2 years with the Washington Spirit of the NWSL. Rumors that there's interest from Lyon in France. Same rumors that have linked Alex Morgan to that club. Rumors for now.
We're going to get a good look at Crystal Dunn. I mean, this is just a defender who bites on that move. It's not even sold that hard. And another cut with her explosiveness. She's just able to go by players. It looks so easy. It's not, of course, but there, just another cut move trying to bend that far post.
Back to live action. Ball knocked out for yet another corner kick for the U.S. This one from the far side of the stadium. And again, it's played in short and quickly. U.S. looking to create something there, but it's broken up. Out for a throw-in.
And this is something I haven't understood with the U.S. team. They keep taking these set pieces, whether they're corner kicks or set pieces in the attacking third, they're taking them short. They have great players in the air to serve those balls in, and I just haven't seen the reward from it.
Ball knocked out of play. Far side by Bruce. That throw-in right into the box. It's allowed to bounce. The turn, Williams. Off the fingertips of Oprah, so it should be another corner kick. Tobin Heath over to take it. Tobin Heath, the most capped player on this particular roster. U.S. to the end line. It's knocked out. This time, it's a goal kick for Oprah.
And again, these short set pieces are not providing results for the U.S. I watched it against Romania on Thursday night, and there were situations where normally the ball would be pumped into the box. And I'm not saying you do that all the time, but I think the default for this U.S. team is serve the box when you're in the attacking third. You have the talent to get on the end of it.
U.S. will find Dunn. It's another big move that the entire ball was out that time, despite some great dribbling on that end line.
Well, one of the things that Jill Ellis learned from the Sweden loss was having players that could break a bunker. And right now we're seeing a bunker by Romania. It's early in the game, but it's looking to personnel. How can they beat it? Is it by getting out wide with service in the box? Is it with players being able to get in the seam and slip that final ball? There's a numerous ways that the U.S. team can break it. Right now they haven't been able to find that final product.
Oh, high from the right. Looking, that's deflected. Dunn pounced on it. The shot is too high. She's been the best player in the field, has the most impact so far, even though no goals.
She's like a magnet tonight. I mean, she's popping up in all the right spaces, all the right gaps. Here, that's the right decision by Ojai, and not enough pressure on Dunn. She's allowed to spin and turn, obviously falling away from that, so hits it over the bar. But she has been impactful thus far, with no production ultimately at the end.
And that whistle, let's go downstairs and hear from Jenny Taft. Jenny, what do you have?
Well, I caught up with Kalia Ojai before the match, and she told me a few things Jill specifically wants to see from her tonight. She wants her to be able to take players 1v1, have that confidence, but also the partnership between Crystal Dunn and Ojai. Jill is encouraging that. She wants to see the chemistry. And Ojai reminded me that this isn't anything new. The two played together at UNC in that 3-4-3, so something they're used to doing. We'll see where it goes tonight.
Thank you, Jen. Roos with a pass. It was intended for Bata. Romania will send this one in. Boyku was the intended target of that. Sent wide on the left. As the U.S. try to get numbers forward. The sprint from Williams, picking it up. Preston Dunn make runs. Williams trying to cut to the inside, taken down, gets the foul. Free kick, U.S.
Just a very well-executed transition from the United States in this one. Williams cuts back into pressure, but ultimately forces that foul.
They went with a quick free kick, and that one is off target. But they want to play high tempo tonight, and that includes free kicks just like that. Morgan Bryan just put it down, and they took off.
And that's a note to Romania. Stay clued in on these set pieces, because the U.S. is not wasting time.
Romania will put this ball back into play. 14th minute, zeros on the board. From the StubHub Center in Carson, California, home of the LA Galaxy. You hear that. Dunn was fouled. Free kick, U.S. Sauerbrunn putting it down. And Margaret Domka said no. Had to wait for the whistle. Long. Center of that three-back formation for the U.S. Sauerbrunn. And it looks like they're going to finish this calendar year in the three-back. We'll see what 2017 brings. They'll play a lot more games and tournaments next year, starting with the She Believes Cup. No dates have been announced yet.
Right, and they're going to face a lot stiffer competition if they opt to go with this three-back, and that's when we'll really see if it can be exposed.
Along with it, has short wide open. Will use her to the left. Press with a nice depth touch there for Heath. And Romania will step in to win it.
Oh, but that's an example of the partnership, the flow. You have Press checking into that gap, and Tobin recreating the pressure on that restraining line with that flick ball to her. That's the push and pull that Jill Ellis talks about. She calls it push and pull. I call it layers of attack, waves of attack coming at you. And this U.S. team has right now been masterful in their movement up top.
Set one by Roos. Boyku. Slowed down. And now help is coming from Ojai. Helping out Sauerbrunn. Nice move by Boyku, but Sauerbrunn doesn't bite. And then that's another foul. Foul on Giorgiou.
And Voigt-Koo was a bit of an island out there. No one was going with her to support her play to win that ball when it was recovered.
Jared Jude just got booked. First yellow card of this match, 16th minute. Zeros on the scoreboard. Romania's brought a very young team here. 10 players on this roster, 21 years of age or younger. Five of them are teenagers, no one over 30.
And there's just a look at the foul. Little pull down there by Jirju. If she gets in the position early, gets in front of her player early, she doesn't have to commit that foul.
Short. Pushing it back. Aly Long. Sauer run. Romania now putting a little bit of pressure on the ball. Ohai doubled up there. Sauer run. Press. Short. Everyone back defending in a sea of yellow. Bata winning it, turning. Turning it back against Sullivan. Mortons pass back. The middle given away to Sullivan. Quick outlet, Tobin Heath. That's how you can try to break down a bunker before it can get set up. Heath still with it. Playing it across. Ohai. Goes wide. Voigt-Koo. Ohai. Right to the goalkeeper, O'Brien. So some good work in this game, Aly, but not the finished product yet.
Right, it's just missing that final piece, whether it's that final ball or whether it's that finishing product. Dunn's had a couple looks and just hasn't been able to put it on frame. And sometimes, as much as you say 90 minutes to go before we go on vacation for a month and a half or so, it's sometimes hard to stay focused in this moment, in this game, when you know that vacation is looming.
Short for Long. Sauerbrunn. 18th minute, scoreless. Morgan Bryan, first one on it. Sullivan. Short. Heath trying to work some combinations. It missed Dunn, swept away by Fiche. Back to the halfway line.
And Romania's not even coming out of their own half right now to pressure the back three of the United States.
Press. Sauerbrunn. Long.
I think Aly Long missed an opportunity there to switch the point of attack over to Casey Short. She's wide open on that left flank.
As that ball is played to her, everyone shifts for Romania. So it's got to be quicker.
You're exactly right, JP. One of the things that the U.S. is doing, it's a bit slow, it's a bit methodical. You've got to ping that ball out there. You've got to play your player that you're passing it to into the space you want them to ultimately attack. It's about setting your teammate up for that next move.
Battle is going to roll out or throw in. Saturday, a big game in the Pac-12 when DeMario Richard and the Arizona State Sun Devils take on Heisman candidate Jake Browning and the fourth-ranked Washington Huskies. Coverage begins at 7 Eastern to watch it live on Fox Sports Go. Throwing for Romania. Far sideline. That's Gorda. Ball is turned over to the U.S. U.S. have had a few chances. Crystal Dunn has looked very sharp. But so far nothing to show for it for the U.S.
No, and it is. It's a little bit slow right now. If I'm Crystal Dunn and Casey Short sprinting to that ball right now, I'm getting there quicker. I'm getting to the throwing quicker. It was high-paced initially, but now it's slowed down a bit.
Aly Long. Sauerbrunn.
And no one is checking to her.
Dunn will pick it up. Ohai makes a move. Dunn stays with it. Played it across off the chest. And that's an own goal.
Unfortunate for Maluta. Dunn made it all happen. They'll take it.
Well, look, sometimes own goals happen because you force errors, you create them. And for the U.S., they created one on Thursday night, and Tobin Heath created it, and this one, Crystal Dunn, just drives end line, whips that ball in. That's why you play that ball, because the defender is running at her own goal. She can do barely anything with it but find the back of the net herself. And you put her under that much pressure, and you're guaranteed, you know, after time and time again, to get created an own goal.
How about the strength of Crystal Dunn, though? She gets bumped there. She could go down, get a foul, get a free kick. She stays on her feet, makes the play.
And she's so strong. Her center of gravity is so low. She's so explosive. You see that time and time again. That's not an atypical thing for Crystal Dunn. But again, she forces that with that ball played in behind the back line. Defender facing her own goal.
Vatapu goes long distance. Short was there. Awkward ball across, but Sauerbrunn gets it. Pulled back by Morgan Bryan. U.S. now with the lead. Goal coming in the 21st minute. An own goal off Meluta.
And the U.S. almost looks like they're in a forefront at times right now when the U.S. is trying to build out.
Bata came in hard. Advantage call there. She went in hard on Andy Sullivan. Heath is wide. Heard out for a throw-in for the U.S.
I know you want to get numbers forward in advanced positions, but right now I think players are running away from the player on the ball too much. Four players on the front line, you don't need that. You need some players checking. You need those layers. It's a bit too flat across the field right now.
West will push it into space off Bryan. Heath cutting inside. Lofts one up. Headed across once, twice. The third time, it's off the chest of control now by the U.S. Hohai. Nice pullback from Sullivan. Sauerbrunn. U.S. moving it much quicker now.
And Sullivan so smart there just to pull that back, realizing it wasn't on with Hohai. But Hohai likes to go 1v1. Jenny Tapp talked about it. And one of the things she has to bring is that combination play. So it's a bright spot for her to see that she tried to combine with Sullivan.
Back for Aly Long in the circle. Sauerbrunn. Slowing it up. Press dispossessed. Fiché. Morton had some help from the back. Screwed away by Gora. The own goal off Maluta, the only goal of the game. She's one of the five teenagers on this club. She's only 17. One of four changes made tonight by head coach Alban. Margaret Dumper spotted a foul on the other side. Despite the objection of Laura Roos, who's playing much more withdrawn tonight. She was up front as pretty much their only dangerous player the other night. Now she's in a crowded midfield in that bunker.
You're right, but she was one of the bright spots for them, and she was running the pitch up and back, 18-18, doing the defensive work, and you probably saw that engine that she has.
Nice ball slipped in. Press couldn't get to it. Cleared out, away from Sullivan. That's Roos, forced back, bad choice, lost it, Sauerbrunn quickly. It's one of the things that Jill Ellis was talking to us about yesterday. When you lose the ball, win it back quickly, constant offense for the U.S. Short, Bryan, laid off by Dunn, intercepted. Romania trying to sneak one on the counter, intended for Roos, who's now up higher. Romania back with it. Bortan, nice up the middle. Octafu's pass ahead. Gora. Brought down by Sauerbrunn nicely. Sullivan. Sauerbrunn. Press. Wide for Ojai. 1v1 at the moment. Try to go to the outside. Stays with it. Doubled up there. And this time, possession lost. But Romania is going to give it right back.
And I think Romania is just doing a better job of having cover closer. They're picking up that second touch by the U.S. when they, in fact, beat the first defender. And they're just being a bit more disciplined in their defending, and it's making it harder for the U.S. to break this bunker.
Short. Morgan Bryan. Short, higher up the field. Deflected ball to Press, wanting to turn. Sending it in. And that's cleared away. Tennant Williams. Short's back on it. Turning it back upfield. Heath on the run. Players open in the box. Slip through. Cleared away. To the right side for Obata. She'll send it up towards Roos. Picked off by Sullivan. Out of Stanford University for more on Andy Sullivan. Here's Jenny Taft.
Well, Jill described Andy Sullivan as playing wise beyond her years in terms of how she plays on the field, her vision, her soccer IQ. And when Sullivan was first brought into camp, Jill told me that Ashlyn Harris came up to her and said, "Where did this girl come from?" And that is exactly what Jill wants to hear. It just shows that these new faces, it's bringing a new energy into the group, and that's exactly what Jill wants.
She's paired now centrally with Morgan Bryan, who to me, Aly, is another player that's playing beyond her years.
I think you're exactly right. And with Andy Sullivan, you know, I credit, as much as people might not want to hear this, I credit a lot of it to that she played with her brother's team all the way through high school. Even long after he had quit, she continued practicing with them. And you're constantly in a high-pressure environment. The game is a little bit faster, so you have to make decisions quicker. And there's just an element of confidence and composure that I believe you can take out of situations like that. And she brings it. I mean, this is a player that has come in and is running the midfield with Morgan Bryan right now.
Ojai trying to slot it through for Press, who was open. Ojai, good fight, good battle. She wins it. Too heavy in the touch, though, and the ball went over the end line for a goal kick for Oprah.
And this game has largely been right side dominant for the U.S. If I'm Andy Sullivan, if I'm Morgan Bryan, and Aly Long, in fact, I'm saying we got to get the ball to the left side. Get it to Tobin Heath. Get it to Kristen Press.
Shea, it's deflected. Williams off the post. It looked like it just skimmed it. Either way, it's wide, and it's a goal kick. She almost had her second international goal.
But this all stems off of the pressure from the U.S. Crystal Dunn loves that. She loves putting defenders under pressure. She gets the deflection. It bounces perfectly to Williams, and she just isn't able to get that one into the far post. She had a couple opportunities in San Jose as well that she didn't finish.
Boyku, terrific ball. Roos had a look over the shoulder, finds it. Your leading goal scorer, Roos, forced wide by Ojai. Stays with it, good job. Here's the cross, not on target. And the foot got stuck in there from Dunn. Free kick Romania as Boyku went down. Good opportunity for Romania on this free kick from about 22 or so yards away.
Absolutely. Sometimes when it comes down to being a little bit overmatched on the field, you rely on set pieces to try to find some joy. And credit to Roos. She had no help. She beat two players and kept possession for her team.
This might be the first tester for Alyssa Nair in goal tonight. Latifu may be the one to take it. Now Fiche is coming up. 22, 23 yards or so away from goal. Back and forth, Vatafu. That's blocked. That took too long. Short, first one on it. Overshot, Press on that pass. Uncharacteristic giveaway for the U.S. there when they had possession.
But way too long on that set piece, and you're not even setting yourself up with your positioning.
Boyku, flag stays down. Boyku after it, winning it, but fouled in the process. She's been impressive tonight.
And I think she was on Thursday night. I do think she's one of the best players for this Romania team. She's very calm, composed on the ball, even when under pressure. She just doesn't have a ton of help around her.
short of the ball. Talking a lot about the U.S. tonight. Let's hear more about Romania. Jenny, you spoke with our captain yesterday. What did you learn?
It was great, JP, chatting with Yona Borton, because she told me that they weren't thinking anything about that score Thursday night. She said, for this team, it is all about the experience. And over these last couple days, since that match Thursday, she's already seen a difference in confidence. She already feels like her players have grown from losing to the United States. Just being around the United States, being in this kind of presence, playing against these kind of players has helped them. And this is a learning experience. It's not about the score.
Seems like they've learned a lot from Thursday, but we're still fairly early in this game. Just past the half-hour mark as Sauerbrunn takes it. Williams. Inside, and she just misses there on the connection to Andy Sullivan. Good run from Sullivan to find that open space.
Well, she's very good in that gap. But back to Romania, they are going to take something out of this. And we're just going to look at this ball right here. Andy Sullivan is up high on that restraining line. And that's something she's not unfamiliar with, because she plays that role with Stanford. She plays the eight, so she gets into the attacking third time and time again.
Voicu knocked out by Sauerbrunn.
But back to Romania, JP. I mean, you talk about learning something. We're sitting 1-0 at 30 minutes, as you alluded to. But it's about the personal responsibility. It's about tracking runners in the box. It's about getting cover closer. And these things, that they know how to do, but they've never experienced at this pace of the game.
That's probably one thing, right, they took out of Thursday night, the pace of it, so they're not surprised by it tonight.
I think you're exactly right, and the U.S. is playing a faster pace than they've ever played. So the U.S. was fast before. They were quick. They were great in transition. But the U.S. has never played at this up-tempo game for 90 minutes the way they have in these last three matches, I would say, against Switzerland and now against Romania.
That throw in, and Giorgiou. Sauerbrunn is there against Roos. Morgan Bryan. Pace is short, 33rd minute. An own goal off Maluta has the USA in front. Now they try to stretch out that bunker. Heath wide. The ball played across, and that's headed out. Corner kick, US. Heath dropping it in there for Dunn. She left it. She thought she had a teammate closer. Short. Heath. Dunn. Offside flag is up. As Press sent it in, but the flag was up and acknowledged by Margaret Domka. Goal kick for Opla.
She might have been offside, and she clearly was, but this is such a good little turn by Dunn. Whoop, through the legs, and then trying to cut that back. She's on the edge. She's on that restraining line.
Batafu. It's going to bounce towards Alyssa Nair, who comes up with it. Nair and Ashlyn Harris have alternated. Not one game each, but a couple at a time. So they've each had an opportunity the last six games. Boyku. Caught off by Williams. Long. Bryan. That's cut off. Bryan looking to recover. Roos, nice touch for Boyku. That's cut off as well. Morgan Bryan looking for a quick move in transition, finding Press. Press worked hard to try to win that ball, but in the end, could not.
And you can see Romania, sometimes they beat that initial defender, they beat that second defender, but they're just not able to hold possession to beat that third defender because the U.S. is swarming them, whether it's pressing in defensively or whether it's with their recovery runs.
Romania will put the ball back into play. Trying to do a little bit better with possession so they don't have to defend most of the night. Wide for Voigtku. Too wide. Throw in U.S.
And there's not even anyone stepping from Romania on Morgan Bryan. Easy outlet just to throw that ball back into play, and you can just see Romania trying to get numbers back.
Sullivan, that's intercepted. Foul goes against Romania. U.S. with it. A slim 1-0 lead. They've had more of the chances, though, that's for sure. As expected, Heath. Head up. Back on her right foot, cutting it back left. Pressure on the ball from Maluta. Sullivan, that's intercepted as well. Horton. Horton again, didn't have enough to move it ahead. Intercepted by Voigtku. Tennifer Roos lost it in front of their bench area. A 1-0 lead for the United States. The own goal came in the 21st minute off Maluta.
And it just looks to me like the movement up top is not as sharp as it was on Thursday night. It's not as sharp as it was in the early moments of this game right now. Players are just a bit stagnant on that restraining line. And they talk about the push and the pull, the layers of an attack, and right now, everyone's just kind of floating into their spaces. There's no change of pace. There's not great dynamic movement.
Aly Long tries that long ball right up the middle. Cleared away. Roos off the chest. Try to lay it off. Dunn. First one on it. Pounced on it. Here's Crystal Dunn. Looking. Try to lay it off. Almost got it back. Quick shot taken. Same Oprah. And she's got it. Lynn Williams was threatening.
And that's Dunn just driving the gap, forcing players to converge on her. She tries to pick up that loose ball, but it bounces fortuitously to Williams. She has a look, but Oprah comes up big in that corner.
Oprah's done pretty well. She's not the number one goalkeeper. Their number one is Andrea Paraluta, but she was not released by her club side, Atletico Madrid. Done. Slotting it through. Oh, high. End line. That went through the fingertips, it looked like, of Oprah. This is where Romania has to be more disciplined. If they could get out of this half only 1-0 down, that's a big plus for them.
That is, and it's a confidence builder. They're doing the things right that they can. They're getting the cover around the ball. They're being disciplined in their tracking. Now they've just got to be more patient defensively 1v1.
Tubman Heath towards the near post. Long was making the run. Headed up. Second ball. Voigtku went after it. Horton. Morgan Bryant got stuck in, and now it's cleared by Romania, but not for long. Sauerbrunn puts it right back up. Brought down, quick shot from Long, flags up on the U.S. Goal kick Romania.
And you know Aly Long is licking her chops on that one, because as much as she loves the opportunity to play in the back three, you know she wants to be further up the field and prove that she's an asset inside this box. And she brings that ball down, has a go with that volley, but it gets the deflection.
Six goals for Aly Long this NWSL season. The year before, 10 goals. Short. Maluta. Horton. Headed for Voigtku, who's now in the middle. Putting pressure on the ball. Long. Long looking closer to Sauerbrunn. Hit the 40-minute mark. Just a 1-0 lead for the U.S. 1-8-1. Over the same team Thursday in San Jose at Avaya Stadium. But Tafu on the wrong side of Boyku. Sullivan. Immediate long ball. The idea was good, but not close enough to Heath. Oprah made a mistake coming out. Won the ball, though. Press was there against her.
And I think more of those balls over the top when Romania has come out of their 18-yard box would serve the U.S. well. It'll soften up that defense, and they will be able to get in behind.
Press. Short. Long. 41st minute. U.S. with a 1-0 lead. Becky Sauerbrunn. Dunn. Still, a bunker is not that easy to play. You still have to be disciplined to play it. It may seem boring to people that are watching it, but they have to be in the right spots to play it that way.
And you can see that they have, in fact, six players on the back line. But it's not just about getting those right spots. It's about tracking the runners. It's about not being pulled out of your position when you think you can get there. You've just got to stay home and stay conservative and keep everything in front.
42nd minute going for the U.S.
And look, this is one of the challenges that the U.S. knows about.
It's going for Romania instead.
If you're playing a bunker, you lock it in. You want to win it in these high spots and attack quickly.
Another throw in for Romania. 43rd minute. 14 players from Olympia Cluj. They're a first place team in Romania, and their coach is this man as well. So he coaches the national team and the top team in Romania. So there should be some cohesion when you have 14 of the 19 from the same club team.
Well, there's definitely a benefit to that, but you're also pulling from a much smaller pool of players than the United States are, for example. So even though you have the familiarity, you might not have the depth.
U.S. will have another throw-in, 43rd minute, up by a goal. We're allowed six subs in this game. And I'm sure we'll see some changes in the second half at some point. Alex Morgan, Julie Johnston among those available, among the bigger names on that USA bench. Press. Brian. Sullivan. Driving one into the box. Fell again. U.S. picked it up. Another corner.
But again, Romania very disciplined in their retreat into their box, picking up those loose balls.
Crystal Dunn drives it out. Heavy touch from Ohai. Romania will break with loose. Try to force that through. U.S. recovers. Dunn. She thought Press was going to make that run outside. Press went inside. Got it down by Sauerbrunn towards Bryan. Romania gets it. Boyku starting back upfield. Switching the point of attack on the right. And the foul on Williams. Taking down Bata.
And you can see confidence is growing within this half for Romania. Not being as panicked when the U.S. puts them under pressure.
Driven long. The U.S. won it, but gave it right back. Back to Fu. Jirju. Tended for Roos. Horton. Royku. Driven ball up for Roos. Too far. Nair away from the line. We'll just pick it up.
And I talked about it in the open, about versatility, being able to play more than one position. And Crystal Dunn now has floated over this right side where Ohio centrally.
Pressing the ball. Hit 45 minutes. Here's Dunn in the box. Dunn with a shot. And a goal. 2-0 U.S. Crystal Dunn is on the board.
Will it pay dividends to get Crystal Dunn on this right flank and isolated? She has been the bright spot for the U.S. in this first half. And look at this ball over all the way to press. She's all alone in that seam. And she doesn't even have to look that second time to play Dunn in. Dunn runs in behind her. That's a brilliant ball by press to split the defenders. And Dunn almost makes her job harder by making her angle worse, but she's able to slot that home through Oprah's legs.
That goal was scored in stoppage time, and it's a tough way for Romania to end the half, but a good way for the U.S. to do it. Crystal Dunn, easily the best player on the field for the first 45 minutes. Probably deserved one earlier, gets one later in the 45th minute. After this break, coming up at halftime, Rob Stone, Heather O'Reilly, Alexi Lalas will have all the first half highlights and analysis, and the look back at the USA versus Mexico in Columbus.
Last play of the first half, it was Crystal Dunn finding net, her 14th goal of the year. She's one of four U.S. players with double-digit goals this year. It is 2-0 at the break for the U.S. women's national team. At the break on Thursday between these two, it was 5-1 for the U.S., so a minor win for Romania at the break. Rob Stone, Heather O'Reilly, Alexi Lalas back here with you. Let's take in our highlights from our first 45, and of course they're going to be dominated by a lot of U.S. opportunities, but very few finishes.
And they're going to be dominated by a lot of this. Crystal Dunn running around, just creating all sorts of opportunities with her speed, picking out crosses.
Crystal had a superb first half, and same with Kalia Ojai. They use their 1v1 opportunities to their advantage. And they're just missing a little bit of separation in the box.
Quick little free kick and a restart right there. And Tobin Heath denied.
Similar to her chance from last game.
Breakthrough moment came here in the 20th minute. Crystal Dunn.
Well, on the surface, it's not beautiful soccer. But you know what? You keep putting that ball in dangerous areas and good things happen. Own goal.
Second straight game, Romania has conceded an own goal. There's Dunn again getting a foot on it. That one should have been put away by Lynn Williams. And here we go, the game's second goal, Dunn.
Again, we see Kristen Press connecting with Crystal Dunn. Crystal doing what she does best, and that's going 1v1, going to goal.
So 2-0 at the break as we're sitting watching this game, Heather, as we take in the stats. I mean, as we knew, it was going to be heavily lopsided in favor of the red, white, and blue, and there's your verification. But what's something you feel the red, white, blue needs to focus on going forward tonight?
Well, certainly the U.S. is winning the ball back where they want to be. In this formation, they're going to high press. They're going to get a lot of opportunities. I think that they've gotten end line very well. I think that because they've had so many opportunities in the final third, it's a little stiff. You know, I'd like to see a little bit more action in the box to separate from their defenders, a little bit more reruns and second and third layers of runs in
Crystal,
the box.
Crystal Dunn creating plenty
very
of action.
Very good. And you might say, well, this is an opponent that is useless in terms of the progression and evolution of the team. Not necessarily, because keep in mind, there are teams that are going to bunker in. You need look no further than the Olympics this summer. Well, when that happens, you got to find ways to break them down. And that's a combination of patience and recognizing the abilities that you have on the field. Obviously, this player right here has incredible amounts of speed. Put her in positions to be able to use that speed in advantageous areas like this, and the good things will happen. You're not always going to win 7-8-0 when a team's bunkering in. So I think a good half from the U.S., some more of those combination play, not just relying on the speed, then you got something there.
The athleticism, certainly two different camps out on the field. The U.S. far superior than Romania tonight. But it is just 2-0 at the break, and Romania very much alive in this one as we close in on second half. Kick play more on the halftime show coming up. The U.S., number one in the world, and up 2-0 on Romania. Plenty more women's international soccer still to come your way tonight. Stay up late for France and the U.S. as they get underway in the FIFA Women's Under-20 World Cup. 12:55 a.m. Eastern live tonight / tomorrow morning. It's a very precise time. We knew subs were coming, and here's the one that so many of the fans here wanted to see. Alex Morgan set to come in for the second half. She had two goals off the bench Thursday night in that 8-1 win over Romania. But here at the break from Carson, California, it's only 2-0. For the second half call, once again, we go upstairs. JP Dellacamera and Aly Wagner.
Thank you, Rob. The own goal off Maluta and Crystal Dunn's goal in the 45th minute. That's the difference in this one. Romania's just made one change. Mara Bata has come in for Alexandra Lumka. And there are three changes, apparently, for the United States. So let's find out what Jill Ellis is doing. Jenny Taft had a chance to speak with her. Jenny?
JP, a lot of changes to look out for. We noticed in that first half, we saw the width in the midfield. We're now going to be seeing the width from the forwards. We have Alex Morgan in. We're going to have Tobin Heath on the left, Dunn on the right. Look for them to be providing the width. She wants to see in the midfield that same mobility, creating the penetration. And Ally Long has moved into that six, so that's something to watch for with Krieger, Becky, and JJ in the back. Defensively, she was pleased. She said they were wasteful with their opportunities, and they need to speed up their play, speed with the ball. Just needs to see a little bit more attack. She doesn't want to let her opponents breathe, guys.
Thank you, Jenny. We're watching the other subs in there. It's a good opportunity, Allie, for Krieger to come in and play in this back three.
Yeah, she hasn't really seen her in the three back much. And Sauerbrunn also moves to the center back position, or the middle of the center backs, I should say, where she hasn't seen her.
First attempt is going to go over the bar. It remains 2-0 USA.
And in the midfield with Aly Long coming to that number six, now Andy Sullivan is in a bit more advanced role in that diamond pinched in midfield. So a little nuance there as well.
Long on it, pushing it back. Johnston for Long. Sauerbrunn to Krieger. Was just recently traded to Orlando by Washington in the NWSL. Long will push it. Morgan Bryant. In the middle for Bortan. Johnston.
And I think this shift in formation is going to benefit the U.S. because they haven't had a lot of success getting into that seam between the back line and the midfield line of Romania, or as much as they had on Thursday night. And Kristen Press will be sitting in there.
Dunn with that terrific first half, dispossessed. USA in the dark uniforms, Romania in the bright yellow. Julie Johnston, one of the three subs that came in at halftime, plays for Chicago in the NWSL. And normally when we saw Julie, like in the World Cup Olympics, she was in the back four. Now it's a back three.
And it's very different look. I mean, Jill likes to say that, listen, we always defended in a back four, but we attacked out of a back three, so this isn't that much different. But when you're playing a straight-up back three system, it is very different for these players. And they have to be able to cover that space appropriately, read the game a bit better, because there's just three back there, knowing when to step, when to drop.
Ball played forward towards Roos. It's interesting. We're only, what, a couple of minutes into this half, and Romania have another sub up by their bench. That always makes me wonder why they didn't make that change right at halftime. Didn't see anyone pulling up with an injury as Roos plays it forward. That's blocked. Krieger. Long. Laid off by Press. Press will receive. Kristen Press slotting it. Done with Morgan on the run. Headed out of the box. Shot by Sullivan. It's deflected into the arms of Oprah.
Well, that was a good looking attack from the U.S. Aly Long getting it, playing that penetrating pass, beating the midfield line into Press in that gap, and her playing that final ball in for Dunn to get in behind.
Pichet with it. Porto Nanu is the other player that's up by the fourth official, waiting to come on for Romania. Started the other night at right back. Played back by Tobin Heath, Bradley Krieger. Long. Sullivan. Dunn held up a run to stay onside. Has a long run for this ball, but catches up to it. Crystal Dunn cutting. Puts it on the left foot. Played it out. Morgan Bryant couldn't get a shot off. Farther out to Long. Knotted down. Krieger. It's blocked. Wojcik Off Johnston, Boyku and Dunn collide. Boyku bounced away with the ball. He's going to be pushed all the way back to Nair. Sauerbrunn. The role of Kristen Press has changed, obviously, with the substitutions made. You've got Morgan Dunn up high with Heath, and now Press is more underneath.
Yeah, she's in kind of that 10 spot, and I do think it's because they haven't been getting a player into that seam, playing making out of there. And she's done brilliantly there when she has played there this year. She gets faced up. She can turn. She can run at that back line. She can release a shot, but she's also capable of slipping on a teammate.
Johnston. Long.
We talk about this U.S. team missing Carly Lloyd. What does it look like without Carly Lloyd? Well, only two goals in the first half. That might be one of the statements. She's a player that would have finished some of those pop-outs, some of those knockdowns in the 18.
Lifter lost it there. Morgan Bryant feeds Crystal Dunn. Sent in. And it deflected wide. U.S. had a chance to make it 3-0 there. The first half score was close, but the stats were lopsided. 11 corner kicks for the United States in that first half, and none of them really produced a goal, but 74% ball possession. Here's the change. It's coming up. Gora comes out. Kodunanu comes in.
Well, that's the beauty of soccer, JP, right? You don't have to control possession. Romania obviously is on the downside of this, but the score doesn't really reflect the way this game has been played, and that's the beauty of it. You can have a team that isn't as talented, and they can execute a game plan and come out with results.
Allie Krieger. Back for Sauerbrunn at the circle. Allie Long giving another deck. Laid off by Morgan. Sullivan. Krieger. U.S. try to make a play there, a combination with Heath and Krieger. That didn't work. It's still the USA's ball. Make six subs. Jill Ellis has already made three of those at halftime.
And I would think someone like Horan would find her way into this match because she's so good in those seams. And Mewis has been great every time she's stepped on the field.
Push back to Krieger. Sent in by Heath. Sullivan. Tobin Heath played it across. Done in the air. It's loose. Press couldn't find it. Sullivan can, but it's wide of goal.
Again, that finished product is being so elusive right now for the U.S. All of that was brilliant. Andy Sullivan's little textured pass with the outside of her right to lay Alex Morgan in with a great run. And just great box organization by the U.S. to get numbers forward, to have that depth and layers in the box, but they're just not hitting it on frame, making Oprah make a save.
Looks like Borton is the player that's down. Here's what happened.
And this ball by Heath, it's the right idea. You can see Dunn's trying to back off and then attack that. Press trying to get on that again. They have the depth, they have the numbers in box, but not the finished product.
And she shakes this off. I want to extend best wishes to Lauren Holiday. Remember in September, she gave birth to a healthy baby girl after Lauren was diagnosed with a brain tumor. In October, successful surgery to remove that benign tumor. You have an update on her.
Yeah, she says she's doing well, that her baby girl is doing well, and she's on the mend. It's been challenging.
Fantastic.
And she's such a strong person and, you know, a role model for everyone before she went through all this, and now even more so.
It's good to get some good news on her. Here's Press of the ball. Heath looking, played it across unselfishly. Press scores! That's goals in four straight games for Kristen Press.
And that's just a thing of beauty from the United States. The player who hasn't missed in the last few matches when opportunities have bounced her way has been Kristen Press. And she didn't get many in the first half, but this one is rolled back perfectly. She sets it up. She continues her run to get in the box. And Tobin Heath, as you said, very unselfishly lays that back. And here's Press. She sees that it's going to be in. She's got to make that delayed run towards that penalty spot and is in the right gap. And just a sweet, calm finish on the carpet to that back post.
Tobin Heath, very creative but also a very smart player. Thought the Press had the better opportunity, and it paid off. Heath, cutting ball in. Morgan Bryan played it across. And now Romania has to really be careful because the momentum is on the USA side here in their scoring.
Well, it was on their side in the first half, but they weren't capitalizing on it in terms of the waves and waves of attack. Well, when this one goes in early, as you said, you've got to keep the wheels from coming off. Stay disciplined in your marks and tracking your runs.
Press. Sarva. Into the box it comes. Press. Bryan. Kristen Press again. Nice move to the outside. Goes back post. Cleared away. Dunn left it for Sullivan, and that one goes wide. Kristen Press continues her hot scoring. That's the life of strikers. Jenny Tapp, what do you know about Kristen Press?
Well, I loved what Kristen told us yesterday, JP, just about how, hey, I'm a striker. I'm expected to score goals. The last thing I was thinking about when I had that hat trick performance was about the goals, because I realized that I need to be doing more for this team. And Jill Ellis has been clear with her that she wants her to step up her game in more ways. That's about that aggressiveness. And she wants to see that from Kristen. She said, the less I'm thinking about it, the more the goals come. And that's what we're seeing from Press right now.
Had a fourth career hat trick the other night. She knows, Aly, goal scorers go into those droughts, if you will. And they also have those hot streaks, as she called it, riding the wave, and that's what she's riding right now. We have a USA player down with Krieger on the ball. The play has been stopped, and that's Morgan. Didn't see what happened to her, but there's always concern when Alex Morgan goes down like that.
Yeah, and she suffered some serious challenges on Thursday night against this Romania team, which has battled injuries throughout her career, and you just hope that everything's okay. And we're going to get a good look here. Just a little heavy touch, a late challenge. Very late challenge by the Romanian player.
And it was Borton, the captain, who was booked for it. Second yellow card of the night. Both going to Romanian players. Morgan's been healthy, though, this year, and her numbers are good on the season. 17 goals in this calendar year in 20 games. That's fantastic.
It is fantastic, and I think the fact that she didn't start tonight points to the fact that Jill Ellis is rating current performance. Alex Morgan's had a great year, but she hasn't given her the start, which means that other players are performing better in training right now. So there's some teeth behind, you know, those statements by Ellis.
What did she tell us yesterday? No jobs are really guaranteed. She wants players to fight for spots constantly. She's getting a little bit aggressive there. Maluta is going to get a warning. And more. A yellow card.
And sometimes if you're coming in and you're facing a big name player like Alex Morgan, they're just a little bit extra in your step, and that's just another late challenge, not even going for the ball.
It's a free kick for Tobin Heath.
And we'll see if they finally whip one into the box on these set pieces in the attacking third. Land this right around the six.
Heath puts one up. It's an inviting ball. Falls to the box. Romania able to clear, but it's coming right back in. Boucher couldn't clear it out. Set across. Didn't settle for Bryan. Roos. Terrific idea. Boyku caught up to it too. Trying to go along for Lumka. It's blocked and cleared by Sauerbrunn in one motion. Press on the ball.
Roos has been impressive for Romania Thursday night and tonight again, and you have to wonder if some NWSL coaches look at her as a player that could be an option.
There are a few good players on this Romania squad that an NWSL club might want to take a look at. Morgan. That rolls out. It's going to be a corner kick for the United States. Tobin Heath will take another, but there's going to be a substitution push. Lindsay Horan is coming in. Crystal Dunn, the most effective player for me on the night, is coming out.
Easily. She was the spark in that first half, wreaking havoc by going at that back line, cutting players, beating two or three at a time. And ultimately, she found the finishing product in those last seconds of the first half.
The Heath corner. Horan's another target. Goes right to goal, though, to Oprah. And Romania have a player down as this ball is cleared out. That's loose. A lot of bodies went after that ball. Off that corner.
That's when she's a player that's not afraid to mix it up. And here she just goes up trying to win it. And looks like she gets grabbed by Horan.
The first leg of the MLS Western Conference Championship kicks off on FS1 next Tuesday. Jermaine Jones leads the Colorado Rapids against Jordan Morris and the Seattle Sounders for a shot at MLS Cup. It all starts at 10 Eastern on FS1 or watch it live on Fox Sports Go. Of course, Jermaine Jones has another big game coming up Tuesday night in Costa Rica. That's the next game for the USA in the Hex.
Yeah, we'll see what starting lineup they go with.
Yes, we will. Been a bit of a surprise the other night, I would say, formation-wise anyway.
Yeah, I didn't think the personnel decision was poor at all, but, you know, ultimately using that formation for the first time with that group might not have been the wisest decision.
Roos is coming out. It could be because of that shoulder. Could be. And Lydia Habrustuk will come in. She too, Lydia, was a starter the other night. So that's three subs made by Romania. But a much better performance by this team tonight. They did learn a lot on Thursday, regardless of how this game ends, just from what we've seen so far.
Yeah, and I thought what was interesting too, or as well, that Albon said if his team had performed the way they did on Thursday night, that they would have found their way into the Euros because they ultimately lost on away goals in a playoff against Portugal. And he thought that they performed strongly against the U.S., and they're improving upon that right now. So this team does have a bright future.
Their next major competition, same as the U.S., World Cup qualifying for the 2019 Women's World Cup, that will be played in France. Lindsay Horan getting closer to goal. Morgan, the shot, and she just missed the far post.
And it looks as though Horan has come in and she's taken over that attacking mid-roll for press. And here she is just driving that gap. Right idea to slip that through to Morgan. And Morgan, that's a great shot cross. Press just isn't able to get on the end of it. But with Horan coming in on the top of that diamond, now Press is up top on that right side.
Is that difficult to keep changing within the game or not?
I don't think so for certain players. And I don't think it'll be a problem for these players. Press is so used to playing up top in any one of those slots.
She has it to the right. Plays it across. It falls for Sullivan. It's a dangerous pass, but the U.S. will collect it. Krieger, Johnston. Allie Long. Not giving much time to the ball. Taken away by Luka. Good job by Luka, number 14 in the yellow of Romania. Strong run up the middle. Luka feeds it on the left. The return pass off target. And Aly Long is on it.
A and that all started just because the ball played to Aly Long wasn't played with enough pace. It allowed Munka to close on it. But the U.S. did a nice job of just funneling that attack by Romania into their numbers.
Johnston has Aly Long. Long started tonight in the middle of that three back. Matches higher up. Quick shot. Right into the arms of Okra. Press after that ball. Some of that defensive pressure she was telling us yesterday. Krieger. Tobin Heath. Doubled up on the wing. Krieger's pass. Sullivan. Wide for Heath. 1v1 at the moment against Coronado. Out for a USA throw-in. Moran. Heath makes the run. Sullivan has it. Drops it back again. Not enough on that ball. Deflected by Bortan. Johnston. Krieger. Horan. 1v1. Into Horan, leaving it off. Andy Sullivan fires it. And that's going to be wide of Oprah.
I'd like to see Horan go wide with that ball. Not back into pressure. Not back into the numbers of the Romanian defense. And we've seen a couple slow passes in this half. And they were watering the field at halftime. I don't know if you noticed, but that's usually to try to speed up things, to try to increase the speed of play for the U.S., but it hasn't paid dividends yet.
Press for Krieger. 67th minute, USA with a 3-0 lead. Press on the deck. Sullivan walking in and bumped at the last moment. Appeals for a penalty kick or not being heard by Margaret Dumka.
Oh, but that was so good. That little run in between the seam and that slip pass by Press.
Sullivan, they're moving it quicker now, the U.S. Morgan, he shot off the post. Could have been, should have been 4-0, U.S. U.S. are back with the ball quickly. Morgan Bryant. Johnston. Sullivan. Bryant's wide, tackled away. She recovers, turns it upfield. She got taken down by Boyku. Will this be a card as well? It will. Yellow card for Boyku. The 3-0 USA lead. Right now they're elevating this into another gear. We'll see if Romania can pick their game up as well. They're going to have to.
Well, I think the U.S. had to elevate it into another gear. It was getting a bit methodical, a bit too slow.
Bryant will take this free kick. Moran beside her. It'll be cut back to Press. And that last U.S. goal, it bounces in the box, given away for a corner by Havlister.
And I keep seeing that set piece in the attacking third, and I don't get it. It hasn't once created a dangerous opportunity for the U.S.
Moving in, and now outside. Tap back. Sauerbrunn. Press. Slotted through Morgan, played it across off Oprah. It'll fall for Bryant. Johnston cutting. Try to find Horan. Stays with the ball. Blocked. Given right back. Krieger. Tobin Heath. 70th minute. 3-0 USA lead. An own goal, plus a goal from Dunn and Press. into the box over Oprah. There's a goal kick coming up. Oprah.
And we talk about how the U.S. can get around the edge when you're facing a team sitting back. Well, how about going right down the heart of the defense? Andy Sullivan knocked off the ball there. She wants a call. We get a good look from just behind. And this is the shot that whiskers the post by Tobin Heath. But again, that play develops all off of attacking down the center of the park. But they did it quickly. That's the difference. If you're going to get going down the heart of the defense, you've got to attack with quick combination play and slice through there the way the U.S. did.
Allie Long is coming out. Samantha Mewis will replace her. Kelly O'Hara has also committed this game. So that's going to be six changes for the U.S.
And I thought Allie Long had a good game. Wasn't tested defensively and offensively. She did what she's done all along, which is play those penetrating passes.
Becky Sauerbrunn and Allie Long were the two players that came out. Sauerbrunn has led this team in minutes played during this calendar year. Horan thought about that shot, broken up. Romania just keeps giving the ball back to the U.S. Having to defend even more than they wanted to. Heath, Horan, nice ball. Heath at the end line, keeping it alive, wants it in the right foot, stays back, goes back. I knew what she was trying to do, but that was tough. Tough to execute there.
You just got to smile. I love the creativity. Tobin Heath loves getting on this end line because it's so fun to dance around defenders. She wants to beat both of them. Keeps it on that right peg, as you said. Tries to lift it up and over. Just heavy on the touch. Great idea.
If anybody could make that move, though, it's her. Foul there in the U.S. Free kick here for Romania. A 3-0 game, a much different game than we saw Thursday night in that 8-1 USA win. That game was really over at halftime.
And we can talk about the finishing product being lacking in the first half, but I also think it was the movement. Yes, they created plenty of chances, but their movement wasn't as sharp. It wasn't as dynamic as it was on Thursday night. No one was getting in that seam between the back line and the midfield line, and that's changed with this shift in formation in the second half, getting that diamond in the midfield, someone to sit in that gap as an attacking mid.
The U.S. will put it back into play. Johnston now has gone from playing wide right in the three back to central with O'Hara on the right or on the left. Krieger's moved over to the right.
And I think Sauerbrunn, who is the one removed for that shift, has had a nice job in the center of that center of defense. It was a position that we hadn't seen her in, and she did well just playmaking out of there and absorbing pressure.
Sullivan. It's blocked. Romania can't clear it out. Could be trouble. Morgan. Side netting. Goal kick. Oprah is the player down. May have injured herself going after that ball. But she is okay. Alex Morgan involved in that play.
And her touch is just a little heavy. It takes her away from goal, makes that ball whipping across the frame all that much harder to play. And she's ultimately not able to wrap it around.
Ball is put back into play. USA with a lot of leaders on this team. For more on leadership, Jenny Taft.
Alex Morgan and I recently had a conversation about leadership, about more specifically a vocal leader on this team. And she said in this transition with so many players retiring and the new faces, some of those roles still really have not been filled, but that's okay. We're still figuring out those roles in leadership, and it's not going to happen overnight.
Back of the ball. Morgan Bryan, and that's blocked. second chance, and that goes wide. We still have Jenny. Were you done? You still want to go?
JP, I can always add something.
There you know go, what
I
mean? There you go.
Well, with leadership, you know, it's just about, you think of Abby Wambach, and she always had that vocal presence with the team, and that was the message from Alex. It's okay that we don't have someone yet, because we have time to figure out who those people are going to be.
Thank you, Jenny. Isn't Alex potentially one of their leaders?
Absolutely. I don't see why not, but I think it points to a bigger issue, if you will, that when you're shaking things up as the way Jill is, a lot of times players that would be those leaders that are more experienced veterans, they struggle because they're concerned with their position, their role on the team. So they don't have the confidence, if you will, to fill that leadership void and to step up and worry about those other players around them and assimilate them into the fold.
This is different, isn't it? We're not used to talking about the USA in these terms because they're always involved in a major competition, right? They're getting ready for World Cup, they're getting ready for Olympics. She doesn't have a major tournament, Jill Ellis, until the 2019 World Cup.
And that's the beauty. That's when you tinker. That's when you do this. That's when you put your veterans, your experienced players in a more stressful situation to see how they handle it. It's when you bring in players to challenge those players. So everything about this is right. It's uncomfortable for those players, but it's still right.
Whether you like the three in the back or not, she's kept it three in these four games, and it's not gotten out of that. So even it's going to go three in the back for the full 90 minutes, it looks like, again, to close out this calendar year.
And they conceded twice, so there are weaknesses in it, things that they need to work on, and I want to see it against tougher opponents.
Played across, Horan didn't get to it in time. Morton, good read there. O'Hara almost took that one in. Great anticipation from Kelly O'Hara. Aly Krieger. Miss Bryan, Sullivan, slight tap, Morgan Bryan after it. She got taken down by Lunka. A very physical challenge there. Free kick. U.S. and a warning for Lunka.
And people may wonder why the three back, right? It's all about getting another player in a more advanced position. And so Jill would argue, we've scored now 20 goals over the past four matches. They've scored 20 goals in this 3-4-3, 3-5-2 occasional system. And so, yes, you may concede, but if you're scoring a plethora of goals, you're willing to take that.
Sullivan in the battle there. Romania have another sub getting ready to check into the game. Tarasila. He avoided that rough challenge. Meruta. Intercepted by O'Hara. Good work there to find Moran. Tobin Heath. Teammates with Portland in the NWSL. Moran sending it across, knotted down. That's Morgan coming through. Several players involved in that. Morgan says deflection, which would have been a corner kick, but the referee says otherwise.
It absolutely looked like a deflection. But I like what Sammy Mewis did. She knew she couldn't get enough on it, so she tries to head that down to Morgan. And this ball just sent back post. No one on Mewis. No one closing her down. So she's got to knock that back across the frame into Morgan's path. And that's a clear deflection. That should be a corner kick.
Substitution for Romania. Giorgiu is coming out, replaced by Beatrice Tarasila. Another one of the teenagers, age 19, playing against the number one team in the world. Great experience for players this young for Romania. Another player from that Olympia Cluj team that has not lost a game this season. 7-0-0 is their record in Romania's first division. Luka was after this ball, but Julie Johnston takes over. O'Hara, Johnston. Krieger's to the right. He'll bypass her instead. It's pushed across. It's Mewis who had that touch. Out for a throw in for Romania. Some support for Romania tonight here in the 80th minute. 3-0 USA lead. That ball is going to be cleared out of play. And this Romania side got to play two games against the best team in the world. Got to see some of California. All is well. San Jose, L.A. Great weather, great stadiums, atmosphere.
Well, you said it. Great stadiums.
Romania want to make other lineup changes, but not just yet.
Yeah, I don't know.
Driven long. Fischer's pass is blocked. Second try blocked as well. U.S. will get to it. Into the box. Too far for Morgan. Sullivan. Bryant. Horan. That was better than in the first half until that last pass. Much better. Much quicker.
But it does seem as though some of these substitutions have disrupted a bit of the flow for the U.S.
Another throw-in, but another sub. Christina Karp is getting ready to check in by the fourth official. The play resumes, so no change yet. Horan, 18 yards away. In for Heath, knocked away. Another corner for the U.S. And now the substitution will be allowed. Karp is in. Cholaku, 18, comes out. Karp is another one of the teenagers, so with each sub, already young Romanian team gets younger.
I'm just 19 years of age, and said it before, but this team has a bright future. Think about how they've come along, and this is really the first injection of marketing, of financial backing to this Romanian team, and they're only going to go up from here.
And Alex Morgan, corner, played short to Heath. Couple of steps there from Tobin Heath. Tackle out. Corner again for the U.S.
And at this point, I have to think that playing short is something that the U.S. wants to work on their set pieces, because they're doing it time and time again.
He drives it across. Not clear it out. Bryant. Trying to play that across. The USA throw it. U.S. with a 3-0 lead. An own goal started it off. Goals by Crystal Dunn at the end of the first half gave them a 2-0 lead at halftime. And then Kristen Press is the only one to get on the board here in the second half. Krieger, Johnston, O'Hara. That ball is going to get away. It's not been a busy night for USA goalkeepers, but the goalkeeper pool needs to be widened, I guess. Jenny, what do you know about that?
Well, in coming into today's match, only 20 caps between Alyssa Nair, Ashlyn Harris-Nair, their 10th cap tonight. And, you know, yesterday she told us it was before Hope Solo's suspension. She'd made the decision after the Olympics she was going to give both of them some time, because as good as they can be in training, they need to get the experience. And with Nair specifically, she said she's been good in the air, she reads the game well, and right now she's seen her presence grow, and that's what she wants to see her continue to work on.
There's other goalkeepers, too, that Jill Ellis may want to take a look at. Adriana French was supposed to be in this camp and then could not be. We've got Jane Campbell, and they were going to call in Abby Smith for the Boston Breakers. She had an injury as well, so the pool might be fairly deep, maybe deeper than we think for goalkeepers.
Right, and she also mentioned Murphy from the U-20s, so she keeps talking about bringing some of those youth national team players. Well, she's one of them. But back to Nair, what I found so interesting when I spoke with her was how every training session is videoed now. So she literally gets calls about her footwork, about spacing from her trainings.
Johnston, 85th minute. O'Hara U.S. Bryant. Final game of the 2016 calendar year for the United States. They will close it unbeaten for the third time in their history. Last time, 2013. Ball played across. That's blocked. Moved away. Press. Running still strong. All the way across. Sullivan stopped by Oprah. Tough angle, but Sullivan did well to get that one close to goal.
She did. You could tell she was in a tweener moment where she didn't know if she should go for a diving header or try to take that off of a half volley. And here she just chested down and tough angle. Oprah covers it well.
Four consecutive starts with Sullivan. What can you say about her and her performance?
She's the future. She's a part of the future easily. I'm not entirely sure where. I do think that six might be her best position, but you can see she gets into that box. She can play an eight.
Tobin Heath. What a finesse pass that was. Moran couldn't come up with it. Well, that was Mewis, number three. In front. That's going to be over. High and wide for Morgan. Romania will take their time, put this ball back into play. Push back to Johnson. Bryant turning. Headed the other way for Kelly O'Hara. Mewis. Was played for the Western New York Flash. They were the champions in the NWSL. Kelly O'Hara outside for Heath. Ryan from distance. Krieger stays on the deck. Press freeing herself for the shot. That's blocked. Appeals for a handball. Not heard. Well, it is heard now. That's a late one. And I'm guessing that that might have come from the assistant referee on the far side, because Margaret Dunker did not call it initially. They're all on headset, and that call was made.
And I was just going to say, we haven't seen or heard from Press in the past 10 minutes since she was shifted out to that right wing spot. But she's the one who creates this penalty.
Morgan Bryan to step up. 3-0 USA lead. On the whistle, it's Morgan Bryan versus Oprah, and a score for Morgan Bryan.
And just a cool, calm finish for Morgan Bryan. Remember in the last match, there was another penalty kick. Alex Morgan wasn't able to convert it. But here's a look at the handball. Press whips that ball in, and her hand is above her head, not in her natural athletic position. And then here the penalty kick. Easily put away by Morgan Bryan. Sends Oprah the wrong way.
Boyku will be subbed out. Loredana Pompa comes in. She's just 17. She'll only get a couple of minutes here. So now a 4-0 game, but still a much, much more respectable scoreline than Thursday night. You also play it to Morgan Bryan. And you can see on that replay, they got the call right. So that's good refereeing, good communication between the officials. Back to Willison Air.
And as much as I hate the handball rule, it was the right call.
Johnston. Slowing it down. USA's amazing streak continues. Looking to add another victory and another shutout to that last note we saw. Mewis blocked. Press wide open. Head up. Looks for options. Cuts inside. Drives it across. Knotted down by Morgan.
And I know you said this team is unbeaten in 2016, but I bet if you ask every player on this field if they lost in 2016, and they will say yes.
Sweep doesn't count as a loss. Counts as a draw, but they all remember that. Felt like a loss. Knocked them out of the Olympics, but it's not recorded that way by FIFA.
Oh, FIFA.
Yep. Our friends, here's Morgan. Trying to put an exclamation point on the night. This was the first time the U.S. didn't medal at the Olympics. A lot of people remember that.
And that's why you're not seeing a victory tour right now. You're seeing the door open for all these players to come in and make an impact.
Heath, cutting. Trying to send it inside, trying to force that ball in. Will she get another corner? She will. O'Hara sending it in. Not it down. There's another one. The U.S. 5-0. U.S.
I tell you what. All Sam Mewis does is come in matches. She doesn't get the full 90 minutes always, but when she comes in, she finds the back of the net. And this is a short corner. It ends up with a service in the box. Sam Mewis just runs at that near post, redirects it back post. No one tight enough. Rather simple finish for her. But look, the U.S. opts to go short, and they actually get a service off of it. And Sammy Mewis is there to clean it up.
Throwing here for the U.S. here in stoppage time. Minimum of 4 minutes added on. We're in that second minute. To the left to O'Hara. 5-0 USA lead over Romania. Played in. That's Heath. Wide open. Looking. Dropping it in front. Press didn't make that run. I think there were so many in the dark uniforms that I don't think anyone knew whose ball that was. For sure.
Good problem to have. Too many runners in the box.
Yeah. Sullivan nods it down. Now it's all the USA with possession as much as they had in the first half. Romania's hardly getting touches in the ball here.
And they just look exhausted.
Sullivan. Horan. 1v1 trying to get free. Heath. Ryan. Krieger. Drives it, and that's wide of Okra. As the U.S. went to their bench, sometimes they brought out even more experienced players than before. When Romania goes to their bench, they get younger and lesser experience, so it's tilted the game maybe even more when you went to the subs. You're bringing in Alex Morgan off the bench.
You're right, that's the luxury that the U.S. has. They've invested in the women's game for so long, and Romania's just getting into the game.
Over 20,000 are watching this one here at StubHub Center. Nice turnout. Sunday evening, USA over Romania by a 5-0 score. Morgan Bryan with it. About a half minute to go. Johnston. Long ball to the right, knotted down. No one there to pick it up. Hit by Maluta. Johnston. O'Hara. Seconds left. Switch by Mewis for O'Hara. That's going to do it. Game over. final game of this calendar year, and the United States has won it convincingly by a 5-0 score over Romania. For our entire Fox Sports crew, I'm J.P. Dellacamera. We say so long from the StubHub Center. Again, the final score, USA 5, Romania nothing. Coming up next is NASCAR Victory Lane from Phoenix.
A dominant 5-0 performance from the U.S. tonight, and I am joined by Crystal Dunn. What a performance to cap off 2016 for the entire team with a lot of new faces, some new formations. How pleased are you with what you saw from not only the veterans but the new players to really end 2016 on a good note?
It's been an incredible couple of weeks, and just adding new players in has been an easy transition. You know, you would think that it's kind of like, oh my gosh, you know, last game we invited 11 new players in. What was that like? And it was easy, you know, with a new formation as well. It's kind of like, you know, we're professionals. This is what we do, and you throw us on the field, and we're going to make the best of our ability. And, you know, like you said, finishing this 2016 off so strong is an amazing feeling.
And for you, you scored your 14th goal of the year, 18th of your career. So safe to say 2016 was a success for you. How confident are you now heading into 2017 in the way you're playing?
I'm on cloud nine right now. I think 2016 was amazing. I think Press and I are actually the only two players that actually played every single game this year. And that's something to be so proud of, because with this game comes a lot of injuries, comes a lot of, you know, you may be playing in game, you may not be playing. And just for me to have that opportunity to step on the field every single time the national team had a game is an incredible achievement. And next for me is just looking forward to a really bright 2017. And I think I'm going to use this year to kind of add on some new aspects of my game. And I think it's looking really bright.
Awesome. Thank you so much for your time. And what a night. What a win. And we'll see you in 2017. Rob?
All right, Jenny, so Dunn and the U.S. women's national team wrap up the calendar year unbeaten, outscoring the opposition 92-10 and pitching 16 shutouts. On the night to wrap up 2016, the U.S. victorious 5-0.